So students, today we are cutting the sections of the brain. This is the whole brain, if you know. This is the dorsal side of the brain and this is the ventral side. If you see from this side, you can see the brain stem, the medulla, pons and midbrain from this side. Also the circle of Ellis on this. So this is the dorsal side of the brain. The first section which we usually cut is a sagittal section, where we divide the brain into two equal halves. So we have already cut the sagittal section. You can see that. See, you have to see the anterior end and the posterior end. If the brain stem is attached, it's very easy to remember that, because cerebellum is at the hind end or the posterior end, right? So this is the anterior end, that is the frontal lobe. This is the part of the parietal lobe. And then you have the temporal lobe, you can see it from this side. And this is the occipital lobe. The four lobes of the cerebrum, and apart from this lobe, for a second, this is the corpus callosum. What you see here is the corpus callosum, and beneath the corpus callosum, one can see the cavity which we call as the lateral ventricle. And beneath the lateral ventricle, this is the part of the thalamus. After thalamus, this is the part of the midbrain cut section. This is the pons, and this is medulla oblongata. I'm just pointing you the parts. See, so when you see it here, this is the anterior horn of the lateral ventricle. This is the central part of the lateral ventricle. And when you poke your faucet inside, you see we have two ways to go. One is towards the occipital lobe, which is the posterior lobe of the lateral ventricle. So this is the thalamus. In this brain we can't see some of the parts, because here there is a septum which covers the one side of the lateral ventricle. That septum is called as septum pellucidum. And after that, here we have a part which we call as the fornix. You have read that the fornix is the commission which connects the hippocampal areas of both cerebral hemispheres on the two sides. And after that we come to this is the midbrain part, this is the pons and the medulla, and this is the cerebellum, and in between one can see the fourth ventricle. So this was the sagittal section of the brain, the total brain. Now let us come to this part. In this brain we don't have the brain stem. So what we can do is we can cut this section of this brain in a horizontal manner. Sorry, this is coronal manner. This was the sagittal. We cut the sections of the brain in three aspects. One was the sagittal, which I have just shown to you. One is a horizontal section, which we cut it like this, in this, so that we see those structures. And the third one are a series of coronal sections, which we start from the most anterior end of the corpus callosum, usually at the genu, then in the middle, and then at the splenium of the corpus callosum. Because otherwise, if we cut more anterior and more posterior, there is no corpus callosum binding the two cerebral hemispheres. So the two lobes will be separate. So let us cut the first section here. Let me see the position of the corpus callosum. So corpus callosum here is visible. And this is the anterior end of the corpus callosum. I am cutting this section at this level. When you cut a section of the brain, you have to pass your knife with a little pressure, and there is no backward movement. See, this is the first section of the brain, which is at the anterior level. What you see here, this bridge, this is the corpus callosum, genu of the corpus callosum, which is connecting the frontal lobe of the two sides, right? So from here the fibers arise, which we call as the forceps minor, which go upwards to connect these areas. In this, what you are seeing is a very small part of the anterior horn of the lateral ventricle, which is visible here, nothing else. But this is the first section which you see here. Now if you see this part of the brain, you again see the corpus callosum, plus also you see a bigger cavity of the lateral ventricle. It is the interior horn, some part of the central part of the lateral ventricle also. Okay? And this is the longitudinal fissure which is visible. So second section I will cut here in the middle of the corpus callosum, with the section which is also passes in the middle of the diencephalon. So we see the structures of the thalamus very clearly. You see here, this is the section. Can you see the vessels also in between? These are the vessels which you see here, and in this section again what we have, you see, this is the corpus callosum which is now forming the roof, and these are the two lateral ventricles. This is the septum pallosum in between, which is separating the cavities. Right? Still, we have not got a good picture of the thalamus in this. Now, see here. In this section, what we are seeing is, can you see this gray matter here? This is the gray matter, and this is a part of the insula which you are seeing on the side.